Today we're going to examine the Athearn 5344 boxcar in a State of Maine paint job for MMA, Montreal, Maine, and Atlantic. To begin, we're going to check the weight. Turn on our scale here, let it zero itself out, place it on the scale. Prefer to place it on its side, keeps it from rolling off. Here we see it has 4.6 ounces. Now that we know how much it weighs, take out our ruler. So you can see on my ruler, I've written the weights right on the ruler. Saves me a little bit of time. Stick it next to the model, it comes in at 7 inches. Should be 4.5 ounces, according to NMRA specs, which is 1 ounce plus half an ounce per inch on the model. Model weighed 4.6, we should be fine. Don't have to worry about the weight today. Now that we know how much it weighs and we know that it's in NMRA spec, we can move those off to the side. Do a double check on the coupler height. Obviously it's better to do this on the rail, it's demonstration purposes only here. But it is in NMRA height specs. Move the coupler gauge and get that out of the way. We're going to begin by dismantling the car today. Take out your trusty Phillips head screwdriver. Mine here is a Stanley one. Got it for fairly cheap at Home Depot. I believe they're about $3 a piece. I don't prefer the jeweler's screwdrivers because they're just too small for my hands. I have troubles holding them. I get hand cramps. I feel like I have arthritis when I'm using them. Set the trucks aside. As long as they don't roll away here, my table is not quite level. Then I'm going to remove the coupler boxes. This part's not completely necessary, but later on in the video series, you'll see why I'm removing these coupler boxes. And this is a roundhouse car, so the coupler boxes are separate pieces for a roundhouse descent. It's actually an Athearn RTR, but it comes from the roundhouse line. Now since I'm removing these, I will no longer need them, and you'll see why again later. I will be replacing them, so I can set those aside. Just toss them here in the box that came with the model. Now that I got the whole car, everything that I don't need dismantled off of there, I can move on to the trucks. I start by removing the wheels from the trucks. Some people don't go through this much effort, but I believe this is the best way to get the model to what you want it to look like. Once you get the wheels out, set these two screws aside for the truck kingpin. I'm using a handy dandy wheel painting mask from American Model Builders. American Model Builders was nice enough to send me one of each, the 33 inch and 36 inch for review purposes. These are designed for KD wheels, but fortunately the Athearn wheels match the dimensions on the KD wheel. And the reason I say this, you may be wondering, for a 33 inch wheel it shouldn't matter, right? Well, for some reason some of them are slightly undersized, the contours vary a little. Sometimes your wheel won't fit. I also have these nice 8 wheel masks from Modeler's Choice. These ones are great, they fit pretty much any version. They don't have the tighter tolerances that the American Model Builders version does. However, you kind of need 8 wheels in it so that you don't damage the extra 4 slots in the mask. You can clean the paint out, but it's just extra effort for me. Now that they're in the mask, I slide a rubber band up, which I keep handy on the base of it. Slide this rubber band up just to keep some tension in the wheels, to keep the wheels in the mask better. Now that it's in the mask, it's ready to be painted. Take my nifty little jig for painting my trucks. Place them on there. This jig is just a simple block of styrofoam with a 1/4 inch bamboo skewer shoved through from the bottom. Once I shove it through, I trim it off on the bottom, push it up just a little more so that they're not, the bottom of the skewer doesn't stick out, and it's a template for my trucks. You must excuse me for the audio in this section. I live right next to the freeway. I'm about 200 feet off of the freeway, so it does get quite noisy. I am painting outdoors. I usually paint indoors in a bathroom with a proper air ventilation. It has a vent system that sucks the air out. The reason I'm not doing it here is the audio in there is even worse than it is outside. Plus, being out in the fresh air allows me to talk without a dust mask on my face to keep the paint fumes out. I recommend that anytime you do any painting, you wear a mask while you're painting. It keeps the fumes, it keeps the toxins out of your lungs. I'm not wearing one right now because it allows me to talk better on the video. I haven't quite figured out the voiceover on my computer yet. This is a new video camera as well, so we're testing everything out today. Now for the trucks, I picked up from Walmart a Krylon Camouflage Brown. I learned about this paint from Rich of Model Trains Weather. If you watch his video series, he uses the exact same color when he does the initial spray painting on his trucks. I use this spray paint on my trucks, and I use it on the underframes, chassis of different freight cars as a base color to start my modeling. When you pick up your model, you want to make sure the paint is well shaken. As you can see, there was a cut in the video there. I had to step out to grab my painting glove. This is just a cheap glove that I bought. It's got the little rubber stickies on it to help me hold the model when I'm painting. And what I do, some quick paint testing there, just to make sure that the paint's coming out properly. I'm going to start by spraying the model, the trucks, from the bottom up. Then switch to the top. Now you can see why I need the gloves. That was it for the trucks. Always make sure you clean the paint afterwards. Best recommendation I ever learned in my life was to clean the nozzle afterwards. Flip it over and spray it out until no paint comes out, and then clean the tip off. What I do is I just rub the tip on the sleeve of my glove. Now we'll move on to the wheels. Here I'm using a Rust-Oleum Rusty Metal Primer. Krylon also makes one. Pick your fancy here. I bought this one because it was the same price, but it was a slightly larger can. What you're going to want to do here, and again, you test spray it. I had to test spray it off camera because I had some problems with my nozzle. And you can do an even coat across either side of the wheels. Then, what a lot of people leave out, which I feel is a missing part of your modeling, is the backsides of the wheels and the axles. Getting the inside from the back is the problem with these masks. Make sure you're very thorough in doing this, or you'll end up with shiny spots on your wheels. We don't want shiny spots. Now again, clean off the nozzle. This one holds a lot more paint because it's a taller bottle. Clean the tip, and you're all set.